Hello, colleagues and friends. This quick tutorial goes over Unpaywall, why to use it, how to use it, and a quick demo of what it looks like when it's being used. So Unpaywall is a browser extension that helps you to find free and open access versions of research articles that you might be interested in. And that might be because you're off campus or you don't have access to a subscription library. So the extension is available for Chrome and for Firefox. If you click on get the extension from unpaywall.org, it kind of senses which of the two browsers you're using, Chrome or Firefox. In this case, I'm on Chrome. And it's pretty quick and easy to do. Here I add it to Chrome. I confirm that I really want to add it as an extension. And when it is ready to go, it shows up on my browser bar there. So Unpaywall has been added. And this is the indication that Unpaywall is now an extension of your browser. And this kind of gives you a quick preview of what it would look like if someone were looking up this article on their web browser. If a free version is available, this green icon shows up on your screen. So Unpaywall is in the browser here, and this is Chrome. In Firefox, it also looks like this. So I've already added it to my Firefox account. So let's say I've looked up an article, and here in my Google Scholar settings, I've set it to check for full text at St. John's. But when I go to find this, I could find it through Science Director Elsevier. But I can also see here that there's a freely available version. So this is same journal article. So we're looking at trends of parent report of healthcare provider diagnosed. And this is the version that comes from the Department of Health and Human Services. So what Unpaywall does is it looks through various different open access directories and databases like PubMed, Directory of Open Access Journals, and it additionally looks through various different repositories from institutions or individual journals. So if you are an open access journal or if you're part of a repository, you can, on this frequently asked questions on the Unpaywall page, you can find a little bit more about the various sources, and you can find out a little bit more information about adding your own repository or your own open access journal so that it too can discover and make your open access materials more discoverable through Unpaywall. Okay, hopefully this is of some help and it kind of shows you why it's worthwhile. I encourage you to look at this unpaywall.org website. Okay, happy researching.